Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. An antiques enthusiast dug up an interesting find at a boot sale this week, when he found some photographic plates believed to be taken more than 100 years ago. Greg Pack, 70, of Canvey Island, Essex, paid just £4 for the precious prints, which were discovered in a wooden box that caught his eye during the fair in Chelmsford. After using modern technology to convert the old negatives, Mr. Pack realized he had picked up a series of family photographs which looked to predate the Great War. This is one of the photos made from the box of glass negatives found at a car boot sale by an antiques enthusiast. It shows a group of children posing for the camera. Photos in those days would have needed the sitter to stay still for several seconds and, sweetly, some of the children in the shots didn't manage it, and a blurred Greg Pack left bought a wooden box at a boot fair in Chelmsford for £4 only to find remarkable old negatives inside, and now Mr. Pack, who used to work in graphic reproduction, hopes someone recognizes the family in the images, which include pictures of children gathered together, a soldier in a uniform, and a man holding a young girl. His son, Scott, 47, uploaded the pictures on Twitter, which now has over 2,500 retweets. Mr. Pack, who studiously visits the boot sale in Marks Tay, Essex, every week with his wife Frances, said, "I have always loved old photos and I found it very sad that they were being sold for a fiver at a boot sale when they should be with a family as treasured heirlooms. I think it's really sad it's not with a family. Honestly, it was emotional when I first saw these people. There they are, a second in their lives more than 100 years ago, and here I am looking at them in 2018. Discussing the ways in which he tried to restore the photographs, he said, "At first I tried scanning them but that didn't work, so I went outside and held them up to the sky and took a picture of them all on my iPhone. After using modern technology to convert the old negatives, Mr. Pack realized he had picked up a series of family photographs which looked to predate the Great War." Mr. Pack said he is taken aback by the interest in the snaps, and hopes the exposure will help to pin down when the photos were taken. He said, "It looks to me like First World War uniform, right, but it could be a French uniform. The list on the lid of the box, that's all written in English, but it's talking about them being taken in France. Then I used Photoshop to reverse them." Mr. Pack said he is taken aback by the interest in the snaps, and hopes the exposure will help to pin down when the photos were taken. "It looks to me like First World War uniform, but it could be a French uniform. The list on the lid of the box, that's all written in English, but it's talking about them being taken in France. Not a lot of people had those sort of cameras in those days, as they were really expensive, so the family must have been well-to-do," the pensioner added. Writing on Twitter, his son said, "My dad was at a boot sale recently and saw this battered old box. He is a fan of boxes, and boxes are made to be opened, so he did what most of us would do and peeked inside. Greg Pack found the precious prints in a wooden box, pictured, that caught his eye during the fair in Chelmsford. The box was actually shut and I like old boxes, so I looked to see what was inside. When I opened it I saw the photographs," Mr. Pack said. "There were a number of plates in various states of disrepair. The bloke wanted a fiver for the box and its contents, but my dad haggled him down to £4. When he got home he held each plate up to the light and took a photo using his iPhone. He then used Photoshop to turn each negative into a positive. Photos in those days would have needed the sitter to stay still for several seconds and, sweetly, some of the children in the shots didn't manage it and are blurred, including one on a toy train. A list of plates in the lid of the box is written in English, but with French names mentioned. They include, in the woods around Honfleur, a port in Normandy, France, while others mention Bonneval Abbey, founded as a monastery of Cistercian monks in Le Cairo, in the department of Aveyron, in the south of France. Names mentioned are Rosie, Tilly Gardner, Florian Henry Mabile. The snaps look to be Edwardian, named after the reign of King Edward VII between 1901 and 1910.